ArcGIS Enterprise is the backbone for running the S3 suite of applications and your own custom applications. It is tightly integrated with ArcGIS Desktop and ArcGIS Pro for mapping and authoring, and it seamlessly connects with ArcGIS Online to share content between systems. It can be deployed in your local infrastructure, in the cloud, or a mixture of both. And every release comes with many new enhancements, and these are some of the key highlights of the latest release. Many improvements have been made to make for a better user experience when working with ArcGIS Enterprise, and whether that's for creating new content, sharing items, or group settings. For example, being able to add items directly from the groups page and the ability to hide what members are part of a group. Starting from ArcGIS Enterprise 10.8.1, the ArcGIS Living Atlas now also contains items for New Zealand, and this allows for easy access to the New Zealand base maps, boundary layers, and LINS-based data layers like the parcels, rivers, and building outlines. And a few key updates have been added for publishing and managing data in ArcGIS Enterprise. A new layer type is the hosted map image layer, and this is similar to the good old dynamic map surface, but with the data stored in a hosted feature layer. It allows for server-side rendering and can use complex symbology and advanced label settings. And you'll need ArcGIS Pro to publish this new layer type. Also new is a simplified way to update both vector tile layers and hosted scene layers. You can update the current layer with a new item. Using the Replace Layer button, you can replace the current layer with a new item. The old item will be archived, and both the URL and the item ID remain the same. Just the data is updated. And for administrators of ArcGIS Enterprise, many improvements have been made as well. You can set default licenses and groups for new members, and you can also show a notice as a header or footer on your portal, for example, to announce when a system will be under maintenance. And you can add site access notices for when people access your portal, for example, for privacy statements or disclaimers. Another major new capability is that you can use groups to migrate content between ArcGIS Enterprise deployments, like dev, test, and prod environments. It allows you to export all content from a group as a file and import that file into another deployment, maintaining item IDs and updating the service URLs. And now let's have a look at the key highlights of what's coming in the next release. And as you can see, there will be many new improvements coming with the next release. We can't go through them all, but there are two key updates I would like to highlight. In the next release, you'll be able to sync data edits both ways in editable layers that are part of a distributed collaboration. And this is a much requested enhancement and will improve the way different ArcGIS Enterprise sites and ArcGIS Online can work together. And it will be helpful for many fieldwork and other editing workflows. And finally, I want to talk about a new deployment option for ArcGIS Enterprise. ArcGIS Enterprise on Kubernetes is a new cloud-native deployment option for Enterprise, designed to optimize scalability, resilience, and maintainability. It is a complete re-architecture of the product based on microservices and containerization. And in this release, it will provide similar functionality to a base deployment of ArcGIS Enterprise. It's meant for ArcGIS Enterprise customers that are already adopting the Kubernetes technology. And ArcGIS Enterprise on Kubernetes will be launched together with ArcGIS Enterprise 10.9, planned for later this quarter.